Hello and welcome to The Witcher 3. So, we are finally in Novigrad and in Novigrad Square, and yeah, we just got here in time for the barbecue, and oh yeah, I suppose you're not too bothered by that. Oh, exactly that. So they also have these rat bastards over here who just hate everybody who's not
move on.
Well, non-human. Hey there. So anyway, we need to go to Triss, and we need to. Alright, okay. People are really chatting in the square, and it looks like she has a house in the middle of the square. Like, that's just crazy, right? So it's been a long while. What the hell would I say? Like, we used to be very close. Like, damn, very close, and I definitely plan to rekindle that. What could I say? I suppose I'm most looking for Ciri now, but hey, I wouldn't mind a day break, you know. Just take a break for a day, you know. So yeah, sounds good. I don't know what, but hey. Maybe something happened, I don't know, but I definitely intend to rekindle the relationship, if that is an option. So, here we go. Oh, what? What? Two tugs? Checking, some stuff? For the house? Yeah, I need to just go get in.
Hey! Sod off! We're looting here!
Well, get lost!
Want you gone by the time I count to three. One.
Hear that?
Two.
Ooh, looky! Thinks he can scare us off!
Three.
What? Get punched in the face! Okay, you wanna... Whoa! Okay, I'm just gonna pull my sword.
We'll split it. Plenty here for everyone.
I'm not a thief. Looking for the sorceress who lived here.
Most likely hiding in some rat trap with the rest of them.
What? Oh, because of those bastards. Why is she in hiding? Well, I just assume...
Who's she hiding from?
Temple guards cracking down. All mages are fair game.
Yeah, they round them up like rats.
Right. So... what do you know about it?
Someone's gotta know more.
I'd look for her in a putrid grove.
What?
Putrid Grove. Interesting, as names go.
A hive of scum and freakery if there ever was one. No decent folk show their hides there.
That why you think I should look for my friend there?
Oh, I meant no offense.
Right, so... Where is it?
Putrid Grove. Where is it?
I wouldn't know. Rumor has it, it's a place for freaks and oddities.
You'd fit in well there.
Maybe. Thing is, gotta know how to get there.
They say you gotta get there through the sewers. But you gotta enter them outside of town. Few know where exactly, though.
Ask a beggar. Or spot yourself a thief. Follow him. Beggars and thieves gotta pay tribute to the king of beggars. Word is, they do it in the grove.
Mean to say the local beggars have a king? Crown? Scepter? And all of that?
Wouldn't scoff, mate. King of beggars, it's a moniker. Yeah, for a man who everyone in Novigrad respects deeply.
And watch yourself. Menger himself don't even go to the grove.
Someone call for me. Wonder why.
It's Menger.
Temple God.
Thieving vermin to the confession chamber.
What, but sir, what's the offense? This is some sorceress bitchy shop.
Think that gives you the right to steal her property?
Well, sorcerers Mages of all types are outlaws.
But by law, the temple guard takes possession of their belongings, and the rule of law still holds in Novigrad.
Did I just kill you already? What?
You know a bat can sniff out a moth a mile away.
The fuck, man? Don't know much about small animals. It's about their hearing, not sense of smell. What do you want?
What's your point?
I ask the questions, Witcher. And as bats sense moths, so I sense freaks. And start by warning them, Novigrad's no place for your kind.
Can I just kill you yet? Who is it for then? Oh, he would love that. Got nothing on me. I don't like either of these answers. How about the screw yourself, go and die? Nah, that's... got nothing on me, yeah. This just kind of says like, hey, I'm innocent, okay?
I haven't done anything wrong.
But you will. Sooner or later, your sort always causes trouble. And this city's mine to protect. Mine. And the Eternal Fires. Nothing I can do to you now. But just know that I know you're here. One misstep, one error, you'll make a mistake is inevitable. I'll be the first to learn of it. And when I do, it'll be standard procedure. Like for every magic oddity who dares taint this city's air. Be seeing you.
Would you come back? I have something to show you. My sword. It has fine craftsmanship. What a fucking idiot. Alright, let's loot. I was just kidding about not looting, of course. I'm a Witcher slash kleptomaniac. So that is all? Oh no, we can just go in. Oh, here we go. His Imperial Majesty, Emmy of an Embrace. I'm pretty sure that I already read that. I'm pretty sure that I did. I'm a bit foggy on what did I read and what not. Oh, what is this? Some, oh, lime bottles, right?
Herbs, roots, just turned to healing.
All right. Mating with a vampire? I like a good story. You will no doubt call me a liar, cheat, and a madman. You will shake your head in pity and snort in disbelief, but I promise you, I swear on all the gods, everything which you shall read in the pages to follow is the truth. The whole truth and nothing but the truth. I met the vampire of which I write years ago in an inn in Beauclair. He introduced himself to me as a Regis and said he was a barber and a medic. Since he looked in every aspect like a mortal man, I might never have even suspected his true nature, had not a fire broken out shortly thereafter in the establishment in which we were residing. This Regis, if that truly was his name, stood completely untouched by the flames, whereas my own clothing quickly caught fire. The vampire carried me out of the burning inn, saving my life from certain death, then treated my numerous wounds. At first, Regis refused to answer my query as to how he had miraculously survived the furnace, like temperatures inside the burning inn without so much as a scratch on his body or hair singed on his head. Eventually, however, he must have sensed I was a man of the world, one who would not jump to hasty judgment based on appearance or species, and revealed his identity, along with a great number of highly interesting facts. According to Regis, not all vampires are alike. This vast family contains both mindless Karakans, feathers, and Akimaras, who in form resemble overgrown bats or far more than humans, as well Ops and Brooksay, who look remarkably like Camille maids. In addition to these, there are the even more powerful higher vampires to which genus belonged my unexpected acquaintance. Not even a witcher can discern a higher vampire from a mortal man. Contrary to popular belief, they cannot be killed by pounding aspen stakes into their chest, nor by cutting off their heads, nor, as I can vouch for based on the... Based on personal experience, by fire. They do not fear running water, garlic, or the symbols of any creed. It might be some consolation to learn a vampire's bite does not turn a human into one of their number, and they do not in any way need our blood in order to survive. To them, it is merely a delicacy in which they indulge from time to time, like men do with fine wine. Regis asked me to keep his tale to him to myself, but now, as I lay on my deathbed, feel that I must share this secret knowledge, even if it means breaking my word to this most noble individual. Well, at least you did it on your deathbed. If I was that Regis guy, I would just use a different name. From time to time.
Hairbrush. Only ever known Triss to use one like this.
What? Really? Oh yeah, hairbrush. It doesn't look that special. And maybe you're not into hairbrushes, like, oh yeah. This is the most unique hairbrush of all time. No one ever uses hairbrushes like this. I've never seen anyone use a hairbrush like this. Like, come on, I just bought him the corner store, okay? Father Adalbert's diary? Pretty sure I already read that. Yeah. So what is this?
Amulets are emanating magic. Gotta be Triss's. She was allergic to potions.
He is? Why do you say was? Signs? I'm pretty sure that I already read that. Steel plates. Alright. Three-story house. Someone really... does this place. Dumpling? Ugh. Rose of Remembrance? Oh my.
The Rose of Remembrance. All dried up.
Oh, that's very interesting. Isn't that the thing that, I gave to her in Witcher 2 that apparently will never wilt as long as I love her? No? So I don't love her anymore? Or what? Did I just forget about her? Hey, for full disclosure, I mean, like, the kind of adventure we had with Kira? I mean, come on. I do care for Kira, but, you know. Just saying, like, oh, that's her top.
Triss's. Never knew her to drop them on the floor.
So that's it? That's all I got? Witcher's not quite the devil you thought. I'm pretty sure I read that too. I don't know, I can't tell which one I read and which one I didn't. Look for thieves on the main square and carefully follow them. So, that is the thing. We found some clues, and I now need to look for some thieves. because that is the way to go. Oh!
Oh, deepest apologies, Governor.
Fetch some metal, you wretch. I've been robbed! Thief!
Where's the thief? Where's the bloody thief?
Howling.
Do I need to... How do I... Do I go this way? Hey, merchants. I'm trying to... Hey, you're a thief, right?
Bloody easy.
What?
Any needs, master?
Okay, I just thought because you have a hood on. Oh! Okay, let's check this out. We'll buy books. We'll purchase books, content not important as long as they are bound in attractive leather and have titles written in gold plate. I wish to display them in my salon in a bid to lend my domicile gravity and sophistication. Helmut Oldberg, photo merchant. Useless. Contract, haunted house. I seek a witcher of unsullied reputation, documentation regarding prior achievements and written references preferred, who will undertake the task of combing the residence on the outskirts of the city recently acquired by the undersigned, Count Kurt Desart, in order to find and drive off or kill the creature which is haunting it. A sizable reward is guaranteed. Sincerely, Kurt Desart, Count of Encore by writ of King Foltest, temporarily in residence at the Kingfisher. Contract, Imp. On behalf of the Merchants Guild, I hereby announce the following. Particularly bold beast, an imp, who are thinking, has taken to thieving in the near market, in the market near the city gates. Though it has not yet harmed any humans, this monster has caused a great deal of irrecoverable financial loss. Whoever tracks down and kills this imp shall receive a hefty reward. One free for all. One free of all taxes in accordance with our honorable city's councilman's decree numbered whatever. Do not tarry in providing us assistance, good people, for retail trade is the backbone of a healthy economy, meaning the financial well-being of the city's merchants lies in all your best interest. Sylvester O'Mello, merchant. Be fair, there's a swindler about. Fair Novigradians, let it be known far and wide that Klaus Federling is a liar, a fraud, and a swindler. The miraculous hair-growing formula he sells is nothing more than, well, from the bits dyed with a modicum of lilac extract. The only effect imbibing this concoction is likely to bring about a debilitating case of diarrhea which will keep you running to the outhouse day and night, fact which I had the dubious pleasure of learning through first-hand experience. Therefore, it is, if this shameless cheat should pay a visit to your domicile, buy nothing and instead tell him to go suck down his own remedy. Walker Olinger. Contract, Monster in the Bits. By the order of the City Council number whatever, reward has been set aside for the killing of the monster which torments and murders residents of the Bits after dark. The only acceptable proof of having performed this deed shall be a trophy taken from the monster's body. Yes, this means your mother's or cousin's or aunt's eyewitness testimony will not suffice, nor will the sworn sword of any other person, regardless of his or her claimed relationship to you, the hierarch or anyone else, and also without caring one whit for his or her alleged trustworthiness, which supposedly can be attested by anyone at your favorite drinking hall. For more information and or to collect the reward see the district superintendent for the bits. Land. By writ of the city council, superintendent of the bits. Best fights. Anyone looking to bash some heads will find plenty of worthy ones in our fair city. Those interested in joining the fun? Sign up for the tournament. You'll face those most highly honorable gents. George's Jork, known as the Pile Driver, Archibald O'Neill, Captain Iron Mortimer, and Durden, known as the Tailor. Alright, you need a cool name to be a fish fighter, okay?
The truth is, we're already dependent on the Black Ones, economically.
Oh, okay, that'll be cool, alright. So, I have this elusive trade.
Guards! Pickpocket!
What?
You know the Ballad of Wanda, who scorned an elf guardian?
So, now I have more quests. I have this elusive thief. That's a Witcher contract, apparently. So I also have some other quests. Eyes of Novigrad. I just do this following the thread. Secondary quest. While wallowing in the bits, Novigrad's worst and most notorious slum, the Witcher took a contract on a monster committing horrendous murders under the cover of darkness. At the time, he never suspected that a story starting in the gutter would end in a luxurious manner. What the hell? Spoiler much? Oh. So, what? Do I go the right way? Crouch! Oh, I suppose.
Greetings!
Greetings! I'm in a hurry. Do you know the shortcut to the. I don't even know. The supervisors there?
This house.
So, did I. Did I. Oh, look at that. We're going that way. Actually, this is a good time to pick up the quest that it's available. I don't even know what quest we picked up. Like that one, perhaps? No, that notice board, obviously. Because it's white now. Makes sense. Alright, we just need to get out. To make some coin too, right? Oh yeah, I'm most definitely looking to make some coin. Have you met me? Well, I suppose not. Oh crap.
Arms for the poor.
Okay, let's just wait till the morning just to see better and partly to not die. Richard, you almost died because... I mean, Geralt, you almost died. We need to rush out.
Once there was a little frog, Rivety Rock.
Maybe they will appreciate our...
You need help.
Our enthusiasm. And they will pay us extra. Monster slaying? Sign me up. Have you got a guard? I came for the job.
Don't like folk wandering around here.
Oh yeah? Well, got a beast you need someone to get rid of? I'm here about the notice.
Supervisor Lund posted it. Yeah, a beast haunts the outskirts, murdering folk. Got them scared to leave their homes after dusk.
Can I talk to this supervisor?
Like to talk to this supervisor.
Too bad he don't receive petitioners.
So what's he do exactly?
Delivers relief on behalf of the city council, flour and groats for the paupers, meaning he don't do it personally. He's got men for that. He himself,
supervisors.
Exactly.
Maybe I can hunt this beast down. I need to talk to the big guy, you know?
I aim to hunt down this monster.
Best hurry then, some other bloke's already after it.
Really? Who? Where did the beast last attack? Anyone see this monster? Someone taking the contract? Who?
Who took the contract?
Didn't see the man. Was just told some brave fool turned up.
Anyone see this monster? Where did the beast attack?
Any eyewitnesses to these attacks?
No, just the bodies. Beast appears only at night. Chooses isolated victims.
Where did the beast last attack?
When do you find the last victim?
Just last night. Hubert, a beggar, but a decent man. I'd let him sleep in the shed from time to time. That one on the right. Eustace hasn't come for the corpse yet. It's lying in there where I found it.
Oh, thanks for that. So long.
Thanks. So long.
So. Alright, we have the dead bum in the
you see in
the
dark
shed.
And your study. Make a fine road snipper.
Oh. I just climb up. Okay, knock this guy into the water.
A witcher, as I live and breathe.
Oh, you lost your fishing pole. Okay. Oh, that's not what I wanted. I wanted to punch him in the water. Ah, okay, never mind that guy. Can we just get in? That's not what I want to do. Can we just... Can we just stop igniting those things?
Serpent eyes, silver sword.
Screw you, man. Are you responsible for this? This monstrosity? Need to examine the crime scene. Somehow. Oh, look at that. Oh, werewolf again.
Not the marks of a garcane or a flutter.
It's werewolf. More werewolves?
Blood, but not human. Monster was wounded.
That ain't good, it's werewolf. Loot? Always werewolf.
Blood's all sucked out. A lesser vampire?
No, it's a werewolf, obviously. Maybe he just kept it for later. Maybe. It's Regis. Vampire.
Ooh.
So he went this way. Pretty big feet for a vampire. Ooh, look at that. Come on, Geralt, don't be like that. That's no need for that. Aren't you guys somewhat concerned about these tracks?
All of them.
Oh, that's gonna be making it hard.
Tracks end here. Ought to look for prints on the other side.
If it's marked, then it doesn't go straight back to his nest. But maybe not smart. Oh, look at that.
Rat corpses. Not a drop of blood left in him. Gotta be an Ekimara.
Really? Do Ekimaras have such a big feet? I already fought the Ekimara once. What? Can I just go in? Actually, this is a good time to take a break, so hope you guys had fun time. If you did, and thanks for watching, and see you next time, guys. Have a good one.